Very much. My name is Abrahams Mwanamwenge, and I should have done this, but she has connectivity problems. Thank you. Can move next slide. Basically, I think the history of cholera in Zambia is that we've had some major outbreaks that have happened, and the early ones happened about in the 1970s when cholera was kind of first introduced in Zambia. And in Zambia, cholera is considered as a major public health problem. And usually every year we find that it's happening around week 40 and week 23 during the rain season. So that's when it usually happens, very rarely outside those periods. So in the year 2021, the country has not recorded any outbreaks. And the last outbreak actually happened in 2018. So it's been quiet for some time, and we haven't experienced much of any outbreaks of cholera since that time. So the country further went on to develop the NCP, which initially had identified at about, I think, a 9 or 10 hotspots, but then we went on again to review the hotspot mapping, and we came up with about 11. And these were Sinazongwe, Monze, Mazabuka, Lusaka being the biggest hotspot, Kapirimposhi, Nkawe, Ngawe, Chienge, Nchelenge, and Nsama. So it's a mixture of hotspots, some which are bordering the DRCs, some are really central, like in Lusaka, and some in the fishing camps. Next. So, like I mentioned before, this slide really shows you when cholera really became a problem in the country, and you could see how over the years it has impacted the country, with sometimes having quite a high CFR and quite a number of places that were actually affected. So this is looking at the epic, if that's how you see the trend of cholera outbreaks in the country. Next slide. Now, when it comes to OCV campaigns, we used previously Shanko during the 21 campaigns, and also previously we've used UVCO, which was used in 2018 and I think a few years before. So after developing the NCP, which really anchored on the major pillars of the NCP, which were WASH, surveillance, OCV community engagement, and case management. So we made sure that all these pillars were put together and a very well coordinating mechanism, which was put in place and anchored in the office of the vice president. We've seen a lot of progress that has happened over time. And hence, when we started doing the preemptive campaigns that we planned, we started in about December 2020 to about this year, December 2021. Of course, we are remaining with about two districts, which are yet to finish. I think we'll finish up those campaigns in January. This has been delayed due to the fact that we had the COVID situation actually impacted negatively on how we conducted our vaccination campaigns, including the coverage surveys, which were affected. So government at the time decided to only allow OCV campaigns. So the coverage surveys were put on hold. We only managed to do in two districts. So as you can see that the vaccination campaigns have had a great impact because we have not had any reported cholera cases since 2018. So we hope it to remain quiet like this for some time to come. Next slide. So just looking at the slide on the preemptive OCV campaign coverages, you see the districts on the left and look at the coverages. Basically, you see that we were scoring around 103 for Chiengi, Kawe 94, and the trend went on like that. We had quite a number of high coverages, except in the second round, we had some lower coverages, especially on Shibuyunji, where we had about 74%. As you may recall, I think we had an election this year, and this is one of the districts, I think, which was closer to the capital. And during that time, we have a mixture of campaigns, political campaigns, and also conducting the OCV campaign was a bit of a challenge. So that's why we had 74%. But by and large, we scored quite high coverages in other districts. You will notice that the last two districts, that is Mazabuka and Kapirimposhi, they are just concluding their vaccination campaign. So we only recorded for the first round here. So we are yet to finalize this month, in the next 1 week or so, for the second round before we embark on the last three next year, Jen. So basically, this is what I was trying to explain in terms of the round. You can move to the next slide. So now, this is a map that is showing you two hotspots. Basically, the other one is a place where we had a low coverage. It's near Lusaka. And the other one, where you see the lakes, it's up north. Now, what we try to do is that when we do the planning for OCV, we try to plan all the possible areas where we think we would find eligible people. And we try to avoid just concentrating on high density areas and overlooking those who might really need the vaccines, although they live very far and quite in smaller portions. So we had to devise a way in which we map out the whole area. And then we use also, we try to send vaccinators to go to these places, which are far flung. This is all in the hope of reaching equity, making sure that we reach also those that underserved populations that really require this vaccine. So how do we verify? So we use independent monitors and also some other national monitors to go into the those areas. Uh-huh. And independently verify the places that, okay, yeah. So independently verify that these places have been reached. So those blue dots that you see are the places where the people reached. And we can verify that these were actually the planned ones. So that's how we verify. Next slide. Next. Okay, so basically on WASH, having developed the NCP, there are also other activities that were going on. So as you see here, this is Lusaka, one of the biggest hotspots. So you see that the community, in partnership with government and partners, they built well-lined toilets to help improve WASH in this community. So we had also a delegation from GTFCC and IFRC that visited to see what kind of progress we're making in terms of WASH. Next slide. So this is typically some of the water sources that people were using to drink water. And you find that just next to it, there's a latrine. So as you know, water would be contaminated and the result is that people get sick. So this is one of the biggest cholera hotspots in Lusaka. Next slide. This is one of the toilets now that has been constructed with the help of the community, in partnership with the community and the government. Next slide. Continued improvement of water in this biggest hotspot in the country. The water systems were installed, although we need to put a bit more. So these are the interventions that have been put in since the last OCV outbreaks. And this is really just targeting that hotspot in the community. Next slide. Some of the challenges that we had was that timing, conducting campaigns during the rain season, it becomes a little bit difficult sometimes, and the acceptability of some pockets and refusals of OCV vaccine due to COVID vaccination, I think that was quite difficult to convince some people. And sometimes we have a problem with the official figures in terms of population. So when you do the forecasting, you find that the actual numbers on the ground are much higher. So that impacts on the availability of OCV, although this has not really been so much this time, but we hope to see that at the end of the campaigns, we will have covered enough populations. And the other problem was the sharp appreciation of the kwacha. it impacted on the resources available to conduct, on the operation of funds to conduct OCV campaigns. Lack of resources also to complete the WASH programs. That was also another problem. Next slide. Well, that's the last slide. Just to show the high political engagement, we had a delegation from GTFCC that visited the Minister of Water and different other ministers just to emphasize to government and partners the need for a multi-sectoral approach and the well-coordinated management of the cholera elimination plan. So this was used as to explain why it was important and explain the targets that we need to reach in order to achieve cholera elimination by 2025 in Zambia. Thank you very much.